So you are finally here. In this place between death and rebirth.
Where yes, I am.
Knows no dawn. Come then. Follow me down into the darkest depths of despair.
Going head first into this shit. See? Welcome to the Dead Ends. Here we go.
Once upon a time, there was a beautiful blue star that fell to pestilence and rotted inside and out. The more its people clung to life, the more they suffered.
That's interesting. It's kind of hard to tell when you're going to get attacked, at least in this first part. Shows like entirely random. Forgotten Steech, though. Why do you ask such a question? Do you not see the plague and pestilence that consumes us? Ours is a world of rancid blood and rotting flesh, where death is the only remedy to suffering. There's no meaning to be found such misery. But it's not always thus. Beneath the waves, we knew only peace and plenty. We wanted for naught and yet craved more, that our progeny might someday flourish as we never could. Eventually, we ventured to the lands unbearing flame and iron, toppling all who dared oppose our might. The world was ours for the taking. Killing footings. Well, that was a silence, not a stun. Oops.
Until they cast not the illness, but their fellow corrupted.
Get rid of the next one. These mobs think they're gonna stop us. Let's go. What the fuck is that? Holy hell. Because I didn't read the other thing before I went to the boss. Wow. See what that says out of curiosity. World is not the boundless paradise we were promised. Our population quickly outstripped the habitable land, while seas we thought would shine forever blue ran dry, spoiled in foraging the tools of conquest, cramped homes turned into squalor, and then came the sickness, our undoing, and the final blessing the star has to offer. We are no longer the fools we once were. Wheresoever life goes, death will follow. Indeed, existence is the most painful path unto nothingness, and the wise embrace of obliteration wholeheartedly. Yeah. Alright, so we're gonna have to pay closer attention to this at the time. There we go, that's better. Oh, that must be the... So you have to do this one over and over again to get your accessories to match your... Certainly, each faithful presence is a sign indeed they understand that we, the global community, are possessed with the wisdom and passion needed to guide our back to the path of righteousness. Yet the freedom fighters dare to undermine us, inviting chaos and disrupt the order we labored so hard to build. They have forgotten the history of the star and its once myriad nations. The wars waged, the countless lives lost, they must be brought to heal the world united under a single standard, no matter the cost. Jesus, is that familiar? Not even aim in the right way. That's where you're wrong. I can. Oh, that's some big shit. We constructed the Peacekeeper, the pinnacle of engineering and technology. This mighty war machine was designed to rid us of the Freedom Fighters as well as any other potential threats to the peace we have so long pined for. Its artificial intelligence ensures that this single function is carried out with cold and calculating precision. Indeed, the 10,000 Peacekeeper units we created have now routed every threat to peace, including us. All that remains is to stand and fight. So they killed themselves with their own technology. Ah, this is a big damn. Yes. Right. And through that. Oh. All right. Get down, one to go. Ooh, I got. There we go. Curious traveler visited our star, a bird which preferred these questions. What meaning does life hold? For what do you strive? I could find no satisfactory answers, only bitter sweet memories of an age-long past. There was a time when we were lesser and in our nescience sought purpose, struggled to justify life's worth. That was, of course, before we achieved perfection. Now condemned to our paradise, we understand the fatuity of existence. Like the fledglings we once were, the poor bird could not accept the truth. It asks us again and again, hoping perhaps our answer might change. Onward and upward, I guess. Answered. Class 2. Oh, here's an essence. Let's read this. There was a time when we yearned to explore the heavens, found purpose in the hope of unveiling life's mysteries, a dream shattered when we reached enlightenment and found it empty. There was a time when we believed in our legacy, thought ourselves baking a worthy path our successors might follow, efforts rendered futile when we discovered the keys to paradise and immortality. As individuals, we struggled to know that was right. Yet in today's perfect unity, there is not left to question. We are infinitely constricted by the finite, but no more. Rala shall grant us the mercy of annihilation. Was there a thingy in here? Did I open it already? There it is. Come on, fending shit. The last mercy, Rala. All right, let's see what this is gonna do to me. That wasn't even the tank buster. God damn. But it's probably been with the trust. Okay, so that was a bit of a mechanic. Come on, trust, don't fail me now. Shit. Let's get it. Whew. Man. That was fun. And there you have it, the dead ends. Where'd our tree go?